it's a pavamanipu, you know, and blissful with my wife also being here. And I felt, you know, I've got a new life. Night I was wishing everybody a happy new year, because the year started for me after we all, you know, threw away our karmas. Amazing experience.
Previously, like when my grandpa died and all that, you know, I used to feel like, okay, death is a bad thing. And like one of my friends also died like very early. So I was like, and their family was like going through very bad phase. So it was like, okay, death is a very bad thing. That was a feeling which always had in my mind. But now it's like, you know, it's one of the happiest thing one can ever have in life.
I can't find word to explain. I couldn't express, and I don't find word to express also. I can only call it as ultimate.
A very big question, $1 million question. Everybody has this question in their mind. Whether there is heaven or hell. If I do good deeds, they say that I will go to heaven. If I do all kinds of bad things, then I will go to hell. Now, before even answering this question, there is one more hidden question is there, which you have not asked. Is there a rebirth, or is there something called reincarnation, or is there life after death? And again, if I start answering this question, you will have, you know, hundreds of questions following it up. Generally, we don't talk about all these things. I don't talk about all these things because whatever I'm going to say, it is just going to be one more story, isn't it? It is not there in your life experience. Something which is not there in your experience, you will either tend to believe it or you will tend to disbelieve it. Now, both these things are not true, because the truth is you do not know. It is going to become one more story, and you're going to say to somebody else, okay, this Guruji told me that there is reincarnation and there is heaven and hell, is what you're going to say. But since you people are very curious to know about this, let me try to put it a little bit logically. Even before even answering this question about rebirth, let me ask you one question, which is a very logical thing. Can there be, see, a lot of Western thinkers, you know, people from the Western world, you know, they always say that there is no such thing as God, there is no such thing as life after death, there is no such thing as, you know, good or bad, heaven or hell. Life starts here when you are born, and life ends when you die. You know, it starts here and ends there. There is nothing like before and nothing like after. You know, a lot of people claim this. Now, I'm asking you a very fundamental question. Now, how can something can be started out of the blue? You create something out of the blue and it runs for a few years, and suddenly they say it vanishes. How can it vanish? Even if you take a piece of paper, if you want to burn a piece of paper, even the paper, after you burn it, it's still there, but it is in a different form. If you burn a piece of wood, or if you burn a house, or if something gets destroyed, you know, you cannot destroy it completely. It takes another form. Now, one form, it is getting converted into another form. Now, there is some transformation happens, but you cannot destroy it completely. Something exists after that. It moves to another dimension, it moves to another dimension and another dimension. It is simple common sense. Similarly, this body and this mind and this soul, or whatever you call it, or consciousness, it cannot, you know, be created out of the blue. And it cannot end abruptly, as you call as death. Even the death, you say something like the being vanishes out of the body. Something goes out of the body. Now, what has gone out of the body? Now, where does it go? You may call it spirit, somebody may call it atma, somebody may call it soul, or somebody may call it divine, or whatever name you call, but something which is there. Right now, the something is talking. Now, something is listening. That which says, I am so and so. When it moves out of the body, where does it go? It cannot vanish. You know, that's what the science says today. But 3,000 years back, the rishis have told, the sannyasis, the sadhus, the enlightened masters, they have told very clearly. But today, modern science, Albert Einstein says, energy cannot be created, neither it can be destroyed, nor it can, you know, it transforms to another thing. You cannot increase it, you cannot decrease it. E is equal to mc square, that's what he says. Now, this theory of relativity, very few people have understood experientially. But intellectually, when you look at it, nobody understands this. So, today the science is slowly getting into it. See, suppose, let me ask you another very logical thing. Suppose you're producing something, forget about human beings, suppose you're producing cars. Say today you produce a brand new 100 new cars. Now, all these cars are produced newly and they all function in one particular manner. If you're producing the same car with the same power, with the same amount of BHP and the power of the engine, say CC or whatever it is. Now everything, the engine, everything is the same. Now the moment you create 100 cars, it all functions in one particular manner. They don't behave in a different way. But when you look at the human being, look at every human being in the world. There are about 700 plus crore population in the world. Every being is unique. Every human being is unique. One person is born with a different quality. Another person is a different quality, with a different mind, with a different body. Your body language, your look, your feel, your psychologically, mentally, everything completely different. You cannot find even one similarity between two beings. Now, how this is possible? It is simple common sense. Now that means what? There is something before the birth. There is something else is happening. In the evolutionary process, you have gone through many generations. And in this particular birth, you are in this particular way. Now one person is an expert in singing. The other person is an expert in dancing by birth itself. Another person is expert in one particular area. Now, how does it happen? If at all you're going to get produced fresh, if life starts at this particular point, how can there be this much of variation? There is a child in UK, I read it in the newspaper and I saw it on the TV, that a three-year-old child is composing, you know, beautiful songs. How can a 3 or 4 year old child compose a song? Who has taught that child? Where did the wisdom come? If at all you want to learn music, you have to spend years to learn all these music. Forget about composing a song. Just to understand the very fundamental of music, it takes years for a person to learn. But how did this happen to a child, a three-year-old child? It definitely comes from the previous birth. So there is no two way about it. Life, it's an evolutionary process. Now, the moment, the so-called death, what you call as death, it is a separation between you and the body, that's all. That which is leaving the body, takes another form, moves to another dimension of life. Before even it takes another body, it goes somewhere. It's a big story. If I reveal all those things, it will become a story. But one thing is sure, when you are living in this life, now look at you. When you truly love a person, you feel so happy. When you really feel gratitude for some other person, and when you extend gratitude to the whole, you know, to your loved ones or to whoever it is, your feeling changes. You know, similarly, when you feel angry with a person, now you suffer. When you feel irritated, when you feel, you know, agitated, when you want to, you know, cheat somebody, when you want to hurt somebody. Now, what is the first thing happens internally is you get hurt. Now, something happens. Now, for different kinds of emotion, now the feeling changes. Now, this feeling is psychological. This is nothing to do with the physical body. Now, the moment you are psychologically affected, now this affects the body. Now, that means when you truly love a person, you feel happy. Now, who gives the happiness? I don't give it to you. It happens naturally, isn't it? Now the existence is giving you happiness. When you truly love somebody, you feel peaceful, you feel happy. When you hate somebody, you suffer. Now both these feelings, it happens at the psychological level. And today the modern science calls it as subconscious mind. When I say mind, mind has got different layers. It's a huge subject by itself. You call it subconscious mind or unconscious mind or collective unconscious mind or whatever mind you call it. Now this psychological aspect doesn't die. It comes with you. The moment you drop your body, it comes, it still travels with you. It is very closely connected to your consciousness. And when you move to another dimension where there is no physical body exist, now you remain in that. Now whatever, you know, karma, we call it karma. You know, again the question comes, what is karma? That's what I told you. When I start explaining all these things, you will get 100 questions. Now the moment you fall, you carry a certain karma. Now you go through a certain process with this physical body. Now the moment you leave the body and you move to another dimension where the body doesn't exist, the soul exists, which carries the subconscious mind, you suffer or you be happy depending on how you lived in this physical world. You know, it is very clear. That's what they say in Hindu culture. There are 7 worlds or 7 realms in this existence before you take the physical form, and it goes on and on. Depending on what kind of karmic structure you have created, depending on how well you are lived with the physical body, now your life after physical will be determined accordingly. And that life has been decided at the moment of death. No two way about it. But right now, some people may believe it or some people may disbelieve it. But, you know, we can prove it experientially. You know, when you come for, you know, higher level of programs, when we conduct programs, we make people experience this. Definitely, there is something in this other world. Now, the whole process of taking this physical body is to dissolve your karmic structure, is to fulfill for what you have born for. If that doesn't happen properly, if people are too busy running behind money, running behind power, running behind woman or man or anything, will not end up anywhere. You know, you're going to come again, come again, come again. Life after death. Punarapi jananam, punarapi mananam. Life goes, life comes back. Again and again you suffer. Because unless otherwise you fulfill this, nothing is going to transform you. So whatever happens psychologically, you will carry it. Whatever happens physically will die. You know, that's why we call it the subtle world creates the grosser element. The subtle element creates the grosser part. What you call as materialistic life will get destroyed. But what is subtle there will never get destroyed. The energy will never get destroyed. It carries on. Say for example, if you take a mango seed, inside a mango seed there is a mango tree which is inside, but it is not visible. It is very, very subtle. Now if you put the seed on the ground, you know, a clear mango tree comes, a neem tree doesn't come, a coconut tree doesn't come. That means what? Even at the state of when the mango tree in the state of a seed, it has already created a beautiful mango tree which is there, but it is not physically visible to you. It is in a very subtle form. Now creation happens in the subtlest form. So this is more powerful than the physical world. Now people are more engrossed with the physical world, but when you truly look at the spirit world rules the physical world. So this process of game of life and death is a beautiful game which the nature is playing with you. Don't ask me why the game is happening. You're already there in the game, so you need to properly address the game. So according to me, when your consciousness or when your subconscious mind is corrupted, then when you leave this body, definitely you're going to suffer in the next life. in the next transformation, in the next form where there is no physical body. And the problem in that world is too complicated. You know, solving a problem when you are in the physical world is much easier than solving a problem in the subtle world. That's why they call it in Tamil, this human birth is very, very precious. Never ever miss this. That's why all these education was there in the ancient Gurukulam. You know, we call it gurus. The gurus have understood this very well, and they used to, you know, transform this phenomenal wisdom to the world. That's why even a king, you know, when a child is born, when the child reaches a certain age, they send the children to the Gurukulam to learn this, to experience this, because only this wisdom can save a person. Nothing else. All this physical world or all the so-called education which is there in the modern days will not help you, my dear friend. This true wisdom about the spirit will give you the proper wisdom, and it will save you, you know, lifelong. What we call the physical world with the body, it's a temporary phenomenon. This is not permanent. This is not the real home. The real home is something else. You need to experience that. You understand? So definitely there is something called suffering or heaven or hell. It all depends on how your psychological life goes on in this world. You understand?